In these streets I don't have a care. It's sweet, sweet, the wind's in my hair. Nothing can make me feel down, down, down. Beep, beep, the neighbors say hi.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna, and if it's your first time stopping by, hello, hey boo, how you doing? So today's video is going to be a whole other hair transformation. I'll be taking you all through this entire spring slash summer vibe hairstyle. You know, we're going to be looking like hot chocolate cakes this summer season. All right. And you all know how much I love me the Yaki silk press texture type of vibe. So this is going to be giving all of that with little to no work at all in literally 5 minutes, and you're ready to dip. But before we get on started with this entire styling process, I'm taking you all through my midweek natural hair moisture routine. You know, you want to make sure that your hair is still staying very juicy, it's staying scrumptious, it's staying very succulent regardless of the styles that you're rocking. So we're going to make sure that our natural hair is all revived from its dry state and it's just staying I normally do this about once or twice a week when my natural hair is out, twice a week during the winter season, and then once a week during the spring slash summer season. But right now, there's a little bit of sun. I mean, let's not trust this sun. This sun is just using us to catch crews. But normally, I do this once a week during spring slash summer, and then twice a week during the winter season. So what I normally do is to go ahead to unravel the previous twist, and then I spritz my hair with warm water. I normally prefer to stick with warm water because I do have low porosity hair, and using heat or warmth just allows your hair cuticles to open up and all of that product to easily penetrate into our hair shafts. Once I'm done hydrating our hair using warm water, I just went ahead to use my Kinky Curly Not Today Leave-In Conditioner, and then to seal in all of that moisture, I just went ahead to use the Shea Butter Mix to seal in all of that juiciness in there, and then wrap this back again into its regular two-stranded twist. Oil my scalp. I'm using this peppermint and tea tree oil that I made by myself. So in this bottle, I do have peppermint, tea tree oil, and then almond oil that I just used to dilute all of that just so it's not too strong. And I use this to oil my scalp. This helps to prevent dandruff, dry and flaky scalp, and all of that good stuff. And then for our edges, if your edges are thinning out, Jamaican black castor oil is your best friend. It's going to help you welcome your edges back. And also, don't forget the nap of your hair. Sometimes I do forget the nap of my hair, so I try not to forget lately, just so everything can be, you know, looking very nice and equal. So now that we're done with this entire midweek moisture routine and applying all of that castor oil to our edges and nap of our hair, we're just going to go ahead right now to move on to the styling process. Okay, this is the exciting part. For me, I can now go ahead to put on my wig cap, and then I'm going to go ahead to fix up my edges a little bit. I'm using the Style Factor Edge Booster Pomade just to swoop my edges and do some, you know, some swoopy here and there. But because the Style Factor Edge Booster Pomade normally turns white on my edges, I normally go ahead to use the Style Factor Edge Booster Gel over top of that just to combat all of that whitish residue. And then I went ahead to tie down my edges using the satin head wrap. And this is basically me 1 hour later. Hello. Hi. To style our hair today, we're going to be using this hair from My First Wig. It comes with all of the accessories you need to use to glamorize and accessorize your hair. It comes with a wig stand, it comes with the wig cap which I'm currently wearing, it comes with your edge brush, and it comes with this little cute purse that has all the goodies you need to install and style your hair. It has your butterfly clamps, your hair comb, and also some extra headbands there that you can use to spice up your look, so that today can be looking like hot, the next day can look like spice, the next day can look like a hotter chocolate. All preference, you have a lot of choices, baby. So this is the hair that it comes in. It's a Yaki textured headband wig in 12 inches, and it's in a cap size small. This is called the Tara headband wig on the website, I think. All the details of this hair is going to be down below in the description box as always for your reference. You all know how convenient headband wigs are, so quick for your errands. If you need to leave the house right now in the next 5 minutes, and you don't want to really do so much to your hair, no gluey, no lace, none of that, just grab your headband wig and you're ready to leave the house. So to install this hair, I just went ahead to grab the combs, the two clips that comes in front of this headband wig, and only clip this and comb this right onto my wig cap as well as my natural hair, just so to give it that extra security, just so when you're trying to look hot, your headband wig doesn't fly off. So I just make sure that it's properly secure, and then I use the Velcro at the back to just slam that in there for that extra security. to take away all of that bumpy rides and to give this headband wig that sleek, yaki, natural silk pressed look, we're just going to go ahead right now to straighten it. I went ahead to use this heat protectant from Kantu, and then I just went ahead to use my hair straightener and just let straighten this in sections while giving it that curved bob shaped look. Like, how can you even finish spring and summer and not even wear a bob unit in this hot weather? Ah, you need something that is bopping, bob and more bobs. To style this hair, we could definitely go ahead to rock this like this, all down, sleek, looking very, you know? But then again, y'all, the back of this hair, I felt like it was a little bit too long. So I just went ahead to trim that right there a little bit just so it fits my entire facial structure. And the length is just sitting really nice. And then once we are done trimming all of those, y'all. Take a look at how this hair is looking luscious. It's moving. The bob is just the whoop. This hair is giving, y'all. And then of course you could go ahead to spice this up to give yourself more of a casual look, to give it more of a spring season type of vibe. I just went ahead to put on this gray headband. I felt it would just complement this entire look. And y'all, just take a look at this hairstyle. And then this next hairstyle we're going to do right now is going to be a half up. What I call this half, this is more like a quarter up and then half down. I just went ahead to put this top part here in a little ponytail using this elastic band. And I just went ahead to, you know, press that a little bit and curve the ponytail using my hair straightener. This is the kind of hairstyle that you rock if you're going to like a casual date with your girlfriends and you want to look like you put in the work, but you didn't really put in the work, just so effortless. Like, you didn't even do too much. This is your casual date today. You're looking very tush, ready for your Zoom classes. You're ready for school. You're ready for work. And then if you want that extra spice, you know, when you have a serious date like this with yourself or with your friends, this one is just going to take the whole look to the next level. Just tuck this hair, flip this ponytail into a nice bun, and y'all, talk about a look. This look is a look. Anywhere you want to go to during spring and summer, this look would just come in handy. It's so unique, it's different, it's effortless. It looks like a breath of fresh air with this entire look, I'm telling you. The messiness and the butterflies that this bun is giving. Even if you're just staying at home, you're looking like a takeaway box without even trying. And then for this last hairstyle, it's just going to be your classic simple low ponytail. This is great for those of us that don't really like hair on our body, don't like hair anywhere around us, or perfect if you're even going to the gym. You know, when you're working out, you don't want any hair around you. This is just going to serve you all of that. So this is basically it, y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to let me know down below in the comment section which of these hairstyles from 1 to 4 was your favorite one. And thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it. And I will see you all in my next one. Have a lovely, wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye.